Today I would like to introduce our project called Palkhi. It's basically a duplex apartment and covers about 6 bedrooms with common living spaces, kitchen and various other service facilities. This particular project is for a family coming from Sangali. So we adopted a sort of a typical Maharashtrian base, you know, as a visual treat, along with some of the materials, for instance, like the Nevasa stone, which you generally see on the temples in Maharashtra. If you look at the apartment with an interesting entrance gets welcomed, you know, with the floral pattern inlaid on the floor with a simple granite and you know, yellow Kota stone. So the steps leads you up to the first floor, and the wall in the front where you actually land on the first landing of the steps. Krishna's, you know, Radha Krishna's painting, which is actually a mural built in a textile art, becomes a kind of a focal point and creates a sort of a very auspicious feel when you enter. As you see, like Shiva temples, the kind of Shivalinga, and there's a constant flow of water, you know, leads you and somehow welcomes you, you know, within the Garbhagruha. And I felt that a little sound of water right in the entrance, the tickling water, you know, would create a sort of a very another auspicious quality to enter into the house. And if you look at the apartment, the whole lower floor is actually a common activity where the kitchen, dining, living and their formal living, a puja room, and of course a master bedroom and a parents room are located on this floor. West facing, you know, the facade, which brings a lot of light and you know, the ventilation through, so that we had to open up, you know, join the view. Of course, is also a fantastic view which overlooks to the Pune University, which is one of the heritage structure. So the character of the place is to allow light to wash, you know, the entire interior, make the interior look much more rustic, and very prominently located puja room, which becomes a part of family deval, which is in form of Ganesha, with the same arch what we observed in Sangali temple. If you walk into the formal room where, you know, the guests are welcome, also has a kind of a facility which can convert into a home theater. So the lounge gets multipurposely used rather than just being a formal. And we have created a screen with the glass in between so that we could also open up, you know, those blinds. What happens that the entire space becomes a one integrated space. So as you go up on the first floor, also we have a right in the front a little study room, which becomes a common activity for everyone together. The lounge where the family actually meets along with the friends, they can have kind of a game areas and relax areas. So the common spaces are meant to intermingle, you know, the family activities, while we could achieve a good spacious quality within each bedroom, especially both the master bedrooms, where the bathrooms, the washrooms are very much integral part of a bedroom. There is one specific procession happens in Maharashtra where we call it a Palkhi, and it's a very beautiful process where thousands of pilgrims, you know, walk together in a process of for almost about 20 days and reach to Pandharpur, where the destiny of Pandharpur is not as important as the process in which they walk along. And I felt that resembles the kind of a thirst and the kind of a process through which this client, the Sargaonkar family, you know, whom I find are the blessed, you know, to be so generous and so honest and so sincere in their approach to put this house together. Knowing all these things, I felt that I must name this house a Palkhi.